I have the King James question here. I mean, it came in pretty late. I mean, we should have asked the DG Finance. He wanted to know what documents does the DG Finance, I beg your pardon, the Director of Finance, what documents does he have to see before releasing money? The thing is, I mean, the government agencies know the procedure. They know the documents that the NCAA has to see or the official ministry have to supply before these things are bought. But here they are, in spite of what the National Assembly said about not approving it. They insist that no due process was followed. So at the end of the day, how do you see all of these hearings from National Assembly and that of the executive arm of government? Where do you see all this headed?
Okay, what I see is the ministries and NACA just defending themselves because they have, first of all, immediately this issue came out, the first thing the new DG did was to call a press conference. He was more concerned about the person who leaked that information. Yes, day before yesterday, they wrote back to Femi Faran and saying, we don't have documents. But somebody leaked these documents, which you were looking for initially, and now you don't have documents. And Nigerians, we are so horrible. We are celebrating. They are coming out clean, or they don't have documents. It's a lie. Somebody sent out these documents, and that was why this corruption was tracked. And we are saying if my sister, Stella, if I am in her position, I would have told Nigerians the truth, apologized, and did the right thing.
You think she's not telling the truth? Or the agencies or the lieutenants are not telling the truth?
I don't think they're telling the truth. What is the truth? It's all glaring that you did not get approval from the National Assembly to buy your security 2 cars. You went ahead and bought them. They gave you approval to buy 25 vehicles. You jacked them to 54 vehicles. You were given approval of 240 million to buy these 25 vehicles, and the vehicles were specified. Helios 25, Helios cars, this other 110, this other 15. And you went ahead to buy the budget what you think is right. There were things you yourself put in your budget proposal and sent to the National Assembly. And based on that, approval was given. And you went out of your way to do things that were not in those items that were approved. So are you telling me that is reading what is coming from them? I have made up my mind. And Nigerians have already made up their mind. Even as bad as the National Assembly is, the Deputy Senate President said, in another claim, in another same society, I read it yesterday, the woman would have apologized and resigned. But here, you will see people defending what cannot be defended.
Were you surprised by those protests in her defense, saying, listen, allow her to do her job? They just want to set her up for nothing.
Anyway, coming from me as a woman, if one, that I was told that she's doing a night job, and actually she was appointed to do a night job. It's only in Nigeria we celebrate people who do what they are paid to do, because in our society, people do not do what they are paid to do. So if she's doing well, I am so glad as a woman that another woman is doing well. And what it tells me is that it's making ways for more women to come into leadership position and do better. But when I see that a woman does these kind of things, it's closing ways for all the things I have spent my entire life fighting for women's participation in leadership and decision making. And a woman, if she's doing well, as I had, and we can see that she's doing well, and there was a threat to her life, we will mobilize the real Nigerians, not cash and carry, not the ones paid for. And the real Nigerian women who know how to make change possible will come and stand in the streets and all corners to say, leave her, she's doing a good job. My mother is not educated, she's in the village. But when somebody was, Dollar King was doing a nice job, they knew her name. They would say, she's our good daughter, she's our good daughter. Every woman identified with her. So they have come up, they've still.
Is that not the same identification or identity people are trying to put on this? Because they say, well, she's doing well, but some people are trying to, I wanted to give you a tweet here, that they're trying to mess her up because, have her support for the president. So, and how do you link that to the protest? Because you said some cash and carry.
You know, hire the protesters. You pay for people. Are you not aware people pay for people to come and protest? And at the end of the day, if you see how they fight for the peanuts, and that is the bane of Nigeria. We need to come to a level in this country. Each time you enter your vehicle, do you feel happy? The jump will be from one end to the other. You will be dancing inside your vehicle. And in the next 6 months, your vehicle will start having problems. On a normal good road, for 2 years, you will enjoy your car. So, and people who are daily basis, borne the brunt of corruption, when you bring 1,000, they come and some of them get like 200 or 500. I have seen people fighting over the crumbs because the leader who mobilized them will take a larger chunk of the money. And then I was in a place where people were fighting. Even T-shirt we couldn't get. And they asked us to come and protest, you know. But Nigerians have to come to a level. We all want good country. Because when you interview people, when you enter vehicles, when you discuss with people, everybody wants to see a good Nigeria. But we have to make effort to pay for that goodness. We have to say no. If you want, for example, if you ask me to come and protest, I say no, I will not. Because there are issues here. If there are people fighting her for doing a good job, for supporting Jonathan, I saw so many people supporting Jonathan. My other sister supports him. He doesn't even know him. He can die for him. And I don't support him because he has not given me reason to do so. I want good governance, and that's where I stand. So if there are people fighting her...
But he has set up a committee to look into this particular matter.
He has set up committee, panel members. Mm-hmm. Yes, let them look into the matter. But the Senate also set up a committee. But we are saying that Stella should actually tender unreserved apology. Even if she didn't know about this procurement process, for it to have happened under her watch. Say, please, Nigerians, I'm sorry. This thing cannot happen. I'm a woman who has a vision.
If you say something wrong has been done, isn't it?
All the things we've been talking, even the things, I read her defense. All the things she says, there was beat, public beat, call for interest and all that, expression of interest. And we have, those things have fallen out flat on her face. Probably she's back from Israel. So those things she said, probably they told her, and she wrote them in response to the query from Mr. President. She has seen now from the House of Representatives investigation that those things did not take place. She even said some NGOs monitored the bid, which now we have seen there was not even any bid at all. So she should have said, this may be some people did this under my watch. And because I was not really watching very well. Please, Nigerians, I am so sorry. For her to still be holding on, even the director of finance and account this morning said, initially it was 70 million. Indeed, I watched it this morning, channels here. And now it was jacked up to 255.15 million for the two cars, Amod cars. So,
because it was got on lease.
Because it was got on lease. And you people ask, why was it? He said, maybe due to guarantee, maybe maintenance, maybe. You know, that's what he was just saying, maybe. Then what I read from it.
These are all the things that, you know, you people usually add to. That's why sometimes it's more expensive to lease than, you know, to buy outrightly. Because if you buy your own car, you definitely will fuel it. You definitely will maintain it. You will be the one responsible for servicing and bad parts and what have you. But this other company will be the one to, you know, do the rest of those things if the car is on lease. All you want is a car in good condition.
With over 200% increase for the maintenance. And I want to believe any new car of that magnitude must get, I told you now, must get at least 3 years warranty. They will service your car free with the mileage. So this issue of maintenance, why I forgave the man is that he said maybe, because maybe means it's under probability. Maybe it's because of maintenance, because of servicing, maybe it's because of guarantee. He wasn't sure. So if he was sure, I would have told him outrightly that it's not possible. This kind of car comes with warranty for at least 3 years free maintenance.
But I you know, the era of bulletproof cars, anyway, look at the front page of the Nigerian Tribune. I'm sure you saw this. Senate queries fan MD over 4 bulletproof cars. That's a different one from the...
And he had a response.
BMW, and he's already responded to them yesterday. So it means that we have loads of them. Perhaps the issue on this one has to do with the pricing and the due process you talked about.
It's also an issue of... We also have to know whether whose security, who security is being endangered here. We have to know. Because so millions of us are walking in the streets and nobody is endangering our lives. So why are they trying to protect themselves? Have we also, even FAN is connected with us, Onaka. Have we also, are we sure that there are these bulletproof, or are they in papers, or are they on ground? Because nobody has seen it.
Look at this comment. Boye reminds us, too, that Mr. Oresi, the executive office of FAN, admitted before the Senate panel yesterday that FAN bought 4 armored cars for Stella Odua for 70 million naira each. So this it couldn't have been on paper.
Okay, if they bought it, I mean they should show journalists, not every Nigerian, these armored cars. If I bought 4 for her and NCAA bought 2 for her, I know she will only ride 1 car at a time. Then let's see the cars that were bought for her. First, we know now you have seen there is difference between the price of NCAA and the price of FAN, which is interesting. We're actually even agreeing that 70 million is too high. But now that there is a group that bought 70 million and another group decided to buy 255.15 million for the two. So you can see that Chamberlain was actually challenging me. Did I say corruption? I am still standing on that issue of corruption. That corruption is involved in all of them, in their purchase. We need to start seeing the cars. They can call press conference at the end of this. I say, journalists, come. Let's show you all the 4 cars from FAN, all the 2 cars from NCAA. So you people can see and know that we actually purchased the vehicle. Then from there, we move to the next level. Why is corruption inherent in the purchase of NCAA? And you people, because many people say, experts, I've been reading people coming out and say, these 2 armored cars cannot be more than 16 million. And now you purchase them with 255.15 million. So there is something actually fishing about it. And that's what I'm saying is that if people are taking our money using this woman's name, because it's not good for Nigerian women, she should come out and say, I'm not part of it.
What if she doesn't resign as you recommended?
Then there is an issue.
What if she apologizes and leaves it at that? Would that be okay?
If she apologizes, it means acceptance of guilty. And the next thing is to say, because you were under your watch, see, things went wrong, deeply wrong. The next thing to do is that you should go. No matter how good you are, you should go.
All right, Amaudi is an anti-corruption crusader. Thank you for coming on this morning.
Thank you very much.